We will now be covering the bones of the appendicular skeleton, upper limb. It starts with the pectoral girdle that consists of the clavicle, and the scapula. Important structures on the scapula include the spine of the scapula, the glenoid cavity, that cavity right there, the acromion process found at the end of the spine up here, and the coracoid process, which is found right here. So glenoid cavity, coracoid process, acromion process, spine. This then brings us to the humerus. On the humerus, we have the head of the humerus. We also have the greater tubercle, which is up here near the head, posterior side, kind of broken on this one, and the lesser tubercle. We also have the deltoid tuberosity, which is found around midway here, deltoid tuberosity. Going down to the distal end, we have the medial and lateral epicondyles. We have the trochlea and the capitulum. We also have the coronoid fossa. And if you flip it around, on the posterior side, we have the olecranon fossa. Then we have the radius. Here's the radius. And the ulna. Ulna with its U-shaped top portion. The radius. At the proximal end, you have the head of the radius, and at the distal end is this little point that is, of course, broken off on this one. There should be a little point down here called the styloid process. And here is the ulna. The ulna includes the posterior side, this bump here, which is the olecranon process. Turn it around. The curve in here is the trochlear notch. This portion sticking out, this lip, that is the coronoid process. And if you go way down to the distal end, that little point down here is the styloid process. So both the radius and the ulna have a styloid process at their distal ends. Then of course this brings us to the hand. The really small bones of the hand are the carpals. These bones here are the 5 metacarpals. Going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then all these little bones where the fingers are the phalanges. There are a total of 14 phalanges. You have a proximal phalange, middle phalange, and distal phalange for every finger except the thumb, where you only have a proximal and a distal.